What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to the Hearthstone Power Hour. We're back for another week. It's looking awesome. It's sounding awesome. We got so much going on this week. I'm so excited. So let me tell you a little bit about who we are, what's going on. I'm your host, Twiz. Chat room, it's good to see you. It's good to see you watching this on the download. Currently wearing pajama pants that are two sizes too small for me. But anyways, outside of that, this show is all about Hearthstone, in case you didn't recognize the layout, everything that's going on around here. And what do? We present a deck to you every single week, a deck that you can take into the meta and try and ladder and just get the best and the most out of this game that you possibly can. But I don't do the magic here, okay? I try and make it look and sound pretty, but it doesn't always go that way. The man behind the magic, the guy behind the what's the wizard? The Wizard of Oz, the man behind the curtain. That's what I was looking for, the curtain. His name, direct from BlizzPro, is Mr. Sexy Stutter. Stutter, say hello to everybody out there.
How's everyone doing today?
Hopefully it's
a good Monday. No one ever has a good Monday. No. Forget I said that.
It's true. It's true. I didn't have a good Monday, so I don't recall the last time I did. So, anyways, lots going on this week, guys. We've got a Mage Secrets deck that we are going to be playing for you guys and kind of demonstrating, talking about all the cards that are in it, kind of how the deck plays, some of the cards you can substitute, some of the better matchups, some of the worst matchups, and what you can kind of expect. So we are available on iTunes. We are available on the BlizzPro YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube, type in BlizzPro, and you will find the Hearthstone Power Hour. All of our previous episodes are there, as well as hspowerhour.com. And we have a Facebook page that you can like if you so desire. I have a Facebook page. Stutter has a Facebook page. Stutter's grandfather has a Facebook page. Christopher Columbus had a Facebook page, and he posted when he was on his ships coming across the ocean, and he found America and everything like that. He was like, "Oh, found America! I'm going to like the Hearthstone Power Hour."
It was pretty slow back then, guys.
It was dial up, but hey, you know, whatever. But anyways, give it a like. We put some decks up there. We let you know when the show goes live and everything like that. So even though I didn't do that tonight, I'm really bad at that. But the reason I did not have time to post on the Facebook page, guys, is there's a couple of things that I want to bring to your attention, okay? First and foremost, BlizzPro has this event going on, all right? And I'm gonna direct you to this. I'm only gonna take up 30 seconds of your time because I want to get into Hearthstone just as much as you guys do. But here's something that I absolutely want you to check out, okay? BlizzPro and Extra Life are doing something amazing, okay? Extra Life, in case you guys don't know, is a yearly gaming marathon where participants gather sponsors or donators that are willing to donate to Extra Life, and in return, the participant pledges to play 24 hours straight of video games. Now, the money goes directly to the Children's Miracle Network and to the hospital of the participant's choosing, okay? In this case, BlizzPro is sponsoring the Kansas University Pediatric Hospital in Kansas City. The money donated helps pay for treatments the children need, as well as helping their families with the various trips to the hospital, and kind of tries to make things better for what really isn't a fun time. Now, here's how you can be involved, okay? You can sign up at extra-life.org. And you can start your own fundraising game. Then on October 25th, 2-5, put it on your calendars, you can join the rest of the gamers out there doing the marathon. And if you can't do it that weekend, that's not a problem. You can choose any day that you want or divide it up into multiple days if 24 hours straight is just too much for you to handle. It would be for me. So you can choose to play any game that you want. Hearthstone, console games, card games, tabletop RPGs, board games, whatever. So it's all about doing something we already enjoy while making a difference in the world around us. So that is one of my favorite organizations, Extra Life. I don't talk about this very much, but my little boy was very sick at one point in time, and I'm here to tell you, I've seen some kids who are in a rough situation right now, and you know, when they spend months and months and years in a hospital, the things that this organization does to help them. I mean, if you have kids, you can probably relate. If you don't have kids, you will someday, and you'll thank yourself for donating and looking into this event. So we don't do it very often. We don't talk about fundraisers and sponsors and this and that and throw your money here and there. But when it counts like this, this counts. Definitely be a part of it. So if you have any questions, feel free, podcast@blizzpro.com. We can give you more information on that. And you guys just saw the website. So.
I mean, just to add on to that, think about it this way. I don't have kids, but just think about it this simple way. you've all probably been in a hospital, maybe not overnight, maybe just for an hour. Mm-hmm. Think about how boring that is.
Right? Right?
Yeah, how boring that is. So you just, they got to do this for countless hours.
And countless hours.
Yeah, countless.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You're just, you know, you're making their life a little better. Absolutely. Just by helping them out.
Do they, like, donate Xboxes and controllers and games and all sorts of stuff? I mean, yeah. Yeah. It's,
yeah.
The writing's on the wall, guys. So, anyways, let's talk a little bit. We'll bring everybody up to speed on, there was a big old Hearthstone tournament, and it was over in Stockholm, correct, Stutter?
I believe so.
Yep, and everybody got together and played the same five decks. So, enough about that. That's, you know, that's one of the problems that I see with this game. And we may as well talk about this just for a minute, Stutter. Here's what I'm seeing, dude. I was on Twitch. I've been watching Twitch for a long time. I've been watching Twitch streamers and everything like that. And I see a lot of the Twitch streams are now EU. Like, where's the NA audience? And on top of that, like I said, I joked about it before, but I'm dead serious. People are playing the same, like, five or six decks. You know, you've got, you know, Ramp Druid, Control Warrior, Zoo. Up until recently, it was Hunter everywhere. I mean, you look at some of these tournament-style decks, they're all the same decks. And it's the same decks that you see in the ladder, and it's like, I can't wait for this expansion for Hearthstone to come out where they have 100 new cards, because I think that the fact that it's the same five decks over and over again is what's killing this game. It's what's killing the audience. And that can't come soon enough. So I'm excited that we're playing a Secrets Mage deck, which is something that you don't see very much of. So I hope it doesn't get stomped. But what do you think?
I'm kind of on the same page there. I think the 20 cards are how many cards was next? Was it 30, 20, 30, something like that? Yep. It wasn't enough. It was not enough at all. And I mean, there's a few different decks out there, like Hunter is back. Everyone knows it, guys. Hunter is back. Paladin is like seen like once in a blue moon. Even though it's not that bad of a deck. I mean, everyone plays Warrior. Everyone plays Hunter, from my experience on the ladder.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone plays Druid.
Yep.
And then you got, like, Hamlock and Zoo.
Yeah.
Oh, and all the bots play Shaman. Yeah. No one else really plays Shaman, but the bots do.
Yeah. Dude, funny story. So, I get on Hearthstone last night, and I'm just going to, like, knock out a few games just to blow off some steam and whatever. And I get on, and I'm playing a Golden Shaman, and it says Trump on it. And I'm like, you know, I get on to just relax and just play a few games, and I come up against Trump, the crap, you know? So anyways, I'm watching, and it's a bot, and I'm like, no way. Like, you know, so after the game was over with, I went to Trump's stream, and his stream was hosting another person's channel, and I was like, son of a gun, Trump's botting. And then I realize, wait a minute, I'm like rank 7, so he's legend by now. So that was probably a different Trump, or somebody with the same, you know, they put the name Trump, but they have a different 4-number extension at the end of it. So keep that in mind, guys, when you look at who you're playing or something like that. I fell for it, and I was like, yeah, I was kind of an idiot, so.
I'm just waiting for the Twitter fallout after that comment.
Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, they're saying Trump's botting. No, it was not the Trump that everybody knows. It was some other guy that really has a problem with creative names. So, anyhow. Okay, dude. Enough crap. Let's go into the game that we all know and love. That is Hearthstone. And let's talk about the Secrets Mage deck and kind of, you know,
how does it how does it work?
I know not, my liege.
Consult the Book of Armaments.
Okay. Let's start, let's kind of break it down here. What do we have? How does it work, Stutter? What is the point of this?
Well, I mean, the point is to get the other player to 0 health. I'm sorry, guys. I just had to say that. So, I mean, the the game, the name of the game for secrets is control the board and build tempo through secrets and through minions, through earlier minions. So you got two mana worms and you got two undertakers for those early minions. You got loot hoarders, which is pretty much just card draw. One thing that's interesting is we're not playing arcane intellect guys, and we're a little more minion based, as you'll notice. Loot hoarders can easily be substituted out for arcane intellect, but we're gonna go with the loot hoarders. But we got undertakers, which is just everyone has been, you know, under the radar saying it's broken, guys. I'm not sure if it's broken, but it's really good. Undertakers. Yeah, you're seeing it a lot more in decks.
Yeah. And they're all labeled Death Rattle decks. Every Death Rattle deck out there has the Undertaker in it, so get ready for...
I mean, the thing is, Undertaker can single-handedly win games.
How so?
Because it's just like, it can roll out, like, just like, Undertaker coin some Death Rattle.
Yeah.
Next turn, Death Rattle. Next turn, Death Rattle. And the thing just keeps on growing, and you can never catch up as the opponent.
Sure.
So you have to, like, silence it, but, you know, not a lot of people are playing Owls.
Sure. Even though that pretty much guarantees we're going to see 422 Owls tonight on the show. Guaranteed. So, anyways.
I love seeing Owls as a mage, because you just hero power and, okay.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Yeah.
But anyways, we have two Frost Bolts used as removal in this deck. As if you're going to use it as a finisher, you need those Ice Lances. You got two Loot Hoarders, we already discussed, two Mad Scientists. This is a little interesting, and I'll go into a little more depth about this card. We're playing a Secrets Mage, so we're playing Mad Scientist because it's a Death Rattle and it boosts the Undertaker. But it's not always the best idea to play Mad Scientist in a Secrets Mage, because... in a tempo Secrets Mage, kind of like what this is, like mid-range tempo-y, you want to control the order of the secrets. And that involves Kirin Tor Mage and you playing them. Obviously, Mad Scientist just kind of puts a random out. But it really doesn't come into play that much, because you hardly ever, hopefully, have two secrets in your hand. But if it does, you know... It's not as ideal as Kirin Tor Mage. But it's upside. So its downside is you don't control the order of the secrets go out in.
Right.
But its upside is that you don't have to play two cards from your hand. So you still have that, you know, card advantage in your hand.
Right. Absolutely. The thing that I don't like about this about the Mad Scientist is if it triggers your duplicate. Or duplicate, again, depending on which side of the Mississippi you're on. Because if it pops and you get duplicate and they kill something else, something stupid, you know, like, I don't know, like your Undertaker or, I don't know. You don't have control.
Loot hoarder, it's kind of annoying.
What I really like, and I got this idea from, Balrog Fan at Balrogfan, who's in the chat room right now, actually, he has a deck designed around duplicating Sludge Belchers. And I mean, you want to talk about just the most annoying wall in the world to try and get through. So when you can control it and you can play duplicate with Sludge Belchers or something like, you know, when you can control what it is that's going to die, that's when you get the value. But the Mad Scientist can trigger it and it can be bad juju.
Yeah, you're absolutely right there. Like if you duplicate like a Water Ellie, or anything better than a Water Ellie, you're golden. I once duplicated a rag. I'm not even joking.
That hurts.
That guy felt bad. I ended the game with three rags on board.
Yeah.
One was his.
And also, you have to watch duplicate against another mage. Because if they polymorph something awesome and then hero power it down, you just got two sheep in your hand.
Bad. Or even worse... against Shaman, you get two frogs.
Yeah, but at least they're taunts.
Yeah.
Which is...
But you kind of have Counterspell to hopefully, you know, be there in case that happens.
Sure.
That's why you kind of want to play Counterspell before Duplicate. You want to play Mirror Entity before all. Mirror Entity should be the first secret out. But anyways, enough about this.
Yes.
Moving on.
Moving on.
We got Harvest Golems, Death Rattle, just Money in the Bank. Moving on after that. Kieran Tormage, next. It's really good in Secrets Mage. One of the issues we talked about earlier is that if you have a secret in your hand and you play Kieran Tormage, it's a lot of cards at once, and you don't like, and you need him to get value.
Yeah.
Because you're really just exhausting your hand pretty quickly.
Yep. You know what? Can I also interject something while I'm thinking about it? Because if I don't, I'll totally lose it. This is one of those decks where you have to really pay attention to what turn your opponent is on. Okay? Because when it comes to, you're going to drop Kieran Tormage on turn 3, and you're going to put down a Mirror Entity, or if it's on turn 4, you know, they could Loetheb on turn 5. What is the primary minion that they're going to play on turn 5? Or, you know, are you going to counterspell on, you know, I mean, what could they possibly play? What is, you know, like, turn 7 for a Mage's Flamestrike. Turn, you know, usually turn 5 generates a Sludge Belcher. Usually, you know, turn 8, you could see a Rag. You know, stuff like that. Being very aware and using these secrets to your advantage, especially Mirror Entity, Counterspell, and stuff like that.
Yeah, Secrets Mage is one of the things where you really got to think about your turns much more than other decks. Like, if you play Druid, it plays itself. You're like, oh, turn 2, Wild Growth.
Mm-hmm.
Turn 3, Sun and Shield Master. Turn 4, and you just, like, you just drop your basically your goal in Druid is just drop your creatures in the order that they come in, and the order you can play them in.
Mm-hmm.
But here, you're thinking about, like, how can I outsmart my opponent and to make him make a suboptimal play testing for a secret?
Yeah.
And that the thing is like, one of the biggest mistakes about playing against Secrets Mage is, like, over-testing for secrets. So it's like, if you have the coin, you can just toss the coin out there and be like, oh, it's not Counterspell. But, like, if you have, like, a one-mana spell that, like, or a two-mana, like, a Wrath that you need, and you're just going to play it to test for Counterspell, it's like, it's just not a good idea.
Sure.
So it's like, people get over-caught up in testing for them, which is a benefit to us. Anyways, moving on again. Fireball.
Standard. Awesome. Removal.
Yes, standard. Exactly. Removal, just finisher, both. Polymorph, we play one, just it's really nice. Deals with all those big threats.
Mm-hmm.
We got two Water Ellies. Water Ellies are just a pain in the butt to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you guys think Sludge Belches are a pain to deal with? Think about Water Ellies are kind of like a... They're as difficult to deal with but a turn before.
Sure.
You see a lot of Water Ellies get hexed. It's absurd. You got Lothem.
Mm-hmm.
Just awesome. Awesome. You got two Sludge Belchers. Pain in the butt to deal with. You know, really combats aggro. Or only taunts, it should be noted. Is it our only taunts? Yeah, it's our only taunts. We got
Sylvanas.
Sylvanas is just value. He's a really good 6-drop. Also Death Rattle. He's a pain in the butt to deal with. That spot could also be taken up by, like, a Black Knight. Or, you know, just a value 6 creature if you don't have either of those.
Mm-hmm.
You got a Flamestrike. Just in case things get out of hand. And then Rag. And, Rag's a nice little finisher. It's kind of like replaces Pyroblast in these decks.
Sure.
But one thing is, we play Flamestrike because it's a good card, but you don't have to play Flamestrike because, you know, if you have the tempo, you're not too worried about clearing their minions.
Sure. Sure. Is there any merit in replacing Rags with, like, Ysera or something like that?
You know, you could replace it in Ysera for, like, the longer style game, but, like, you know, this is kind of a mid-rangey deck, so you don't want to play Ysera because Ysera is so late game targeted.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But you could play, like, an Antonitis and, like, get some value out of that, maybe.
Sure.
Because I've done, like, I played a Secrets Mage before, like, a long time ago, and you could do, like, This play has happened to me once, and I played Secrets Mage a long time ago. You play Antonitis, Kieran Tormage, and Counterspell. Oh. Woo.
That is That is beastly. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So, alrighty. I say we give it a whirl.
Let's do it.
I say fire in the hole, shall we? Let's do it.
Yeah, one of the things with Antonitis is if it gets faceless, it's a huge problem. Because a lot of other, like, if you get faceless by, like, a warrior, they have a lot more cheap spells.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. I feel ya. Hey, also, guys, just so you know, I added some soundboard stuff. I have a feeling that this is Handlock, and I don't know why. Let's see what he mulligans.
Well, I'll get rid of everything but the mana worm anyways, no matter what.
Yeah, he mulliganed his whole hand.
Yeah. We could have kept the polymorph if we thought it was Handlock, but we're really just... Okay.
Or not.
Just mana worm.
Yeah, mana worm turn one.
Yeah.
All day long. And you know what? We made the prediction that Freeze Mage, with the Hunter nerf and everything like that, Freeze Mage was going to be really something. And,
I would Mana Worm. Here we go. Mana Worm coin.
And then
just ping his Undertaker.
Yeah.
Actually, we could have pinged his, Yeah, we should have pinged his Abusive Sergeant.
Well, you know what, though? I mean...
Because if we pinged his Abusive Sergeant, then he would have had to boost the Undertaker, which... clearly it didn't matter.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I'll just play Mad Scientist.
Yeah.
This is... Oh, my God. I hate Zoo so much.
Yeah, Mirror Entity kind of sucks here. Because I don't think, other than Doomguard, he's going to play anything that's really of super value.
I mean, he's a bot also, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Good call. I didn't even notice that. And you will notice the bot.
I would play Undertaker, and then I would just play Mirror Entity.
And you'll know it's a bot, because there's no arrows going into any of my minions.
Oh, come on. Worst thing to mirror. See ever. And he gets the knife. Man. I'm just low thumb.
So yeah, mini GRN, mini green giant. Nice bot, dude.
All right, well, we're gonna have to Sylvanas and hope we live. Oh, we could Sludge Belcher. But that won't really do anything.
We'll stall out most of his minions, won't it?
Yeah, but we'll just stall out the next turn when we can ping there. I think Sylvanas is the better stall, to be honest. If that second card is a Doomguard, he wins, but... But they always do this. There we go. Bots cannot place around Sylvanas. They just can't do it. They're somehow not capable of it.
Oh. Now there's arrows.
Oh, yep.
He's back.
I would play Sludge Belcher, then ping his Argus. Can't believe you pulled another Doomguard, man.
Of course he did. Why wouldn't he have?
I would play Water Ellie, and then I would Fireball his Doomguard.
I was thinking about Fireballing his Doomguard and Fireballing his 3-3. Because that leaves him with...
I think Water Ellie's better, because I think we can Fireball next turn, and it allows Water Ellie to take out another minion. It's better long run.
So, and we're going to Fireball the Doomguard, right?
Doomguard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Man. Zoo's difficult with this deck, because we don't have any early board clears, and we need to draw Flamestrike.
Yeah.
The good news is he doesn't have any Doomguards left, so if you control the board, we should be alright now. Yeah, let me just go face the entire time. You face Mongol, you.
Yeah, I think that hoses us.
No it doesn't. We can live. If we fireball the... We can live with one... If we fireball the 3-3...
If we fireball the 3-3, polymorph the 1-1, and take out the 2-2 with our 3-6.
Well, in that case, we just polymorph the 2-2, and then take out the 1-3. It's the same thing.
Okay, so walk me through your way, just in case.
So, fireball the 3-3.
Yeah.
You gotta polymorph the 2-2. Yep, and then take out the 1-3.
Yeah. I think my way... I thought my way left... What did it leave on the board? I thought it left I thought it only left two damage on the board.
No, because he's always going to leave... Wow. Buddy, you didn't need to... Well, that's it.
Yep, that's
you can just
that.
Concede. What? I mean, buddy, come on. Yeah. You didn't need to tap all those times. All
right,
just...
guys, for those of you who have small children listening to this, it's time to put the earmuffs on, just to let you know.
And I want to look them straight in the eye, and I want to tell them what a cheap, lying, no-good, rotten, four-flushing, low-life, snake-licking, dirt-eating, inbred, overstuffed, ignorant, blood-sucking, dog-kissing, brainless, dickless, hopeless, heartless, fat-ass, bug-eyed, stiff-legged, spotty-lipped, worm-headed sack of monkey shit he is! Hallelujah! Holy shit!
I recorded that from Stutter the last time we lost to Zoo.
That probably about pretty accurate.
It's probably... Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. Another it's going to be one of those days. I hate Zoo, guys.
Yeah.
Keep Mad Scientist and Frostbolt and get rid of everything else. Yeah, keep Kirin Tor Mage, I guess. It's a 3-drop. How? Why? These people...
I think you think coin out Mad Scientist?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and the chat room is blowing up. They're like, dude, Zoo always puts me on immediate tilt. Again. One of the 5 or 6 standard decks you see.
Winter Blaze Lal. Yes, I do also hate them. Mad Scientist. I don't like... I don't know. I just don't like the...
I know.
Zoo and Token Druid are like the same thing, guys.
But I don't know. I would almost rather lose to a Token Druid than Zoo. Just cause
I would, yeah.
Zoo's just so slimy.
But we all knew Zoo was going to be huge. Kirin Tor Mage Counterspell.
Not today, my good man. Not today. It sucks, though, because he didn't have to lose a card to trigger that.
I'll play Water Alley. Mm-hmm. And go face, 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 face. We probably shouldn't have attacked the last one. Probably should have sacked one into the 4-9 to get an extra secret.
Sure.
Great. I would play Harvest Golem. Mana Worm. Yeah, that's fine. Yep. I was gonna say maybe Mana Worm and then Curator Mage instead. Just the 4-3.
Yeah.
I would play Curator Mage. Mirror Entity. Ping the 2-1.
Ping the 2-1.
Yep. Go face with the other ones.
Oh, boy. So we got Counterspell and Mirror Entity going here. Cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So many Lothabs.
All the Lothabs.
I would Lotheb, honestly.
You think Lotheb over Sludge Belcher?
Yeah, definitely Lotheb over Sludge Belcher. Because what we're going to do is we're going to trade... Well, our Lotheb that we can attack with into his Lotheb. And then we're just going to have Lothebs all over the place.
Man. Multi-Theb.
Yep. And then we're just going to ping his 4-3. Trade in the Harvest Golem. And go face, yeah.
Chat rooms, dude, how many Lothabs can possibly be in one game?
Well, if you duplicate them, a lot more.
Okay. You got the Taunter, or... No?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just kill him with frost bolts.
Yeah.
To the face.
Yeah. Yeah. I was like, wait, can it really be that easy? Can that really happen? Is that how this just happened? Three. Yeah, that just happened like that. So. Oh man.
There we go.
Man. He's probably like. Top deck and Sun Gun. But anyhow. So man, chat room, what are you guys
that's
doing?
Right.
You guys are rocking it out here. I'm sorry, I don't pay as much attention to the chat room as I should. You guys sit here and have such a great freaking time, and then I read on Twitter about what a great time they all had in the chat room, and I'm like, well, I should have paid attention. So I'm gonna can all this.
Mm-hmm. Even though Water Alley is really good in this matchup because you can just freeze their weapon all the time.
Yeah.
But we need that tempo. There's that Undertaker. That's perfect. Especially in this matchup.
Yeah.
Ooh, this is pretty good. It's a pretty hot start.
Yep. We'll see how it goes. Loot Hoarder or Mad Scientist?
A little mad scientist all the time. Because we want the mad scientist to die more than the... Like, who want the loot hoarder to die, but it just cycles. The mad scientist will give us more value. Because it will make sure we don't draw a card that we... Harvest Golem. Yes. Man, look at that curve out.
And what do you think? Face for all of it?
Yeah. If this was Hunter, obviously we'd sack the...
Yeah, we'd sack we'd that Haunted Creeper, because they can Houndmaster it and do all sorts of crazy nonsense and whatnot.
Well, I would ping the 2-2, 2-1, sorry, 2-1. I would run in one of the 1-2s into his 1-1. I would kill both of his, It doesn't matter which one you kill me. He's consecrating next turn. So what we're doing is we're playing around consecration by doing that, and we're hitting him with the 2-2.
Yeah.
And I don't want to drop Loot Hoarder into nothingness.
Sure. Yeah, just for the sake of drawing a card.
Mm-hmm. But I think that Loot Hoarder is the next turn. This is going to be a consecrate turn.
Nope.
Wow.
Shade.
I think Mana Worm, Loot Hoarder.
We don't have Loot Hoarder. Oh, Loot Hoarder. Sorry, I was thinking Harvest Golem.
I was like, yeah, we...
We're going to...
We were just discussing this.
But we've got... I don't know. We're coming up on a consecrate turn, so it's kind of like, how much do we want to put on here?
Yeah, then we can just go face with the rest.
Should I sit on Loot Hoarder, you think?
No, Loot Hoarder's fine. Loot Hoarder, like you said before, cycles, and we have an easy turn 6 play with Sylvanas, and just ping his face and go face. Yeah. We'll be face mongrels for today.
That's fine.
If we wanted to play this very interestingly, we could have pinged the mad scientist.
Ah. I'll tell you what. So we're coming up on turn 6. Oh. There it is.
Well, if he's going to...
Okay. Not today, my good man. I think ping one, take one out with the other Loot Hoarder or the Harvest Golem, and then drop Sludge Belcher. Or no, I can't because I won't have enough mana.
What I'm thinking is, I'm thinking we just drop Sludge Belcher, and we take out the Shade of Nax with the Harvest Golem. Yeah. We can also drop Sylvanas, but I don't think that's good. I think Loot Hoarder or the Sludge Belcher is the way to go. Yep. And then if we can get off a duplicate, that'd be huge.
I don't think we're going to.
We can drop Sylvanas into that, and I think that might be the play. I think also duplicate Loot Hoarder ping his guy is actually a good play. I think that's a play, actually. Duplicate Loot Hoarder. And then ping his Sludge Belcher.
And then should I kill...
No, because if we were going to kill that into that, we should have pinged his face.
Oh, okay. So just sit on this because, then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're hoping that's going to take out his token after. Uh-oh. What's that going to give us?
Two Sludge Belchers.
I would do Sludge Belcher, Mana Worm. And then I might Frostbolt his 3-3. Yep.
Yeah. I like that. I like that.
Because he shouldn't... He might have Equalities left, but he doesn't have any Consecrates left. Maybe a True Silver at work.
Aranya. She says, I named my cockroach Guacamele yesterday. For those of you who are from the TwizzCast days. That is very excellent.
Do we have lethal?
6, 9.
Yeah, we're like one off.
10.
I would drop Sludge Belcher. Ping his 1/1. Frostbolt his face. And go face with that, yep. Because now we can't gain health with that. If he gains health, though, with like a lay on hands, the next play would be easy Sylvanas.
He's going to heal. Or not. Oh, yeah. That's a very... So that's 3, 4...
That's still lethal.
That's still lethal.
Because you still fireball his face.
That's exact lethal.
No, it's 1/1. Buff on the minion.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Buff on the minion. So, there you go.
There we go.
There you go. That... I like that. I like that. We'll do that.
Yeah, so just discuss Secret Mage. Secret Mage is still its infancy, guys, as a deck. But we have a little more mid-range build. You're going to see a lot more of Secret Mages as, like, tempo and, like, really aggressive. You get, like, Leper Gnomes in there, and you get, like, stuff like that instead of, like, Rag and kind of, like, the more control-y cards. That's where a lot of people are going to, but I kind of like the mid-range a little bit more. I think it's a little more consistent. I think it's a little more fun.
Sure. Exactly. We're all about fun here. Secret, yeah. I've got a secret. I haven't played that yet. I can't believe I've gone this long and I forgot to play that.
And you were probably like, what's wrong with me?
Yeah. Oh, Balrog. He is exactly right. Oh, this is a different person. We'll see how this goes. That was, in fact, a hee-haw win. There's no doubt about it.
Is this the same person?
No, different person.
Oh, just get rid of everything. We want those one drops, guys. Those are not one drops.
Nope, they're not. But we might draw one right here. Or we might... Oh, my God. Holy cow.
This is a bad hand, guys.
This is a bad starting hand. Bad starting hands.
I always respect the golden paladins because they're just like, why?
Yeah.
Like, I'm impressed with you winning 500 times with this. Just, you know. But why did you do that to yourself?
I got nothing. They do have pretty cool tokens, but Shaman are definitely cooler, just for saying.
Shaman are cooler. Yep. Yes, they are. I'm tempted to Frostbolt that. I think that is the play, Frostbolt it. Or we could Mirror Entity. But I don't like Mirror Entity on turn 3. Because then you get a 3-drop with it, and you're like, eh.
Does Mirror Entity trigger with a token?
No.
No? Okay. I never played
it. I think Frostbolting is the way to do it. Because we'll just have an easy turn 4 play with Water Alley anyways. Yeah. I assume anyone with golden paladin bots. Actually, I haven't heard of a paladin bot ever. Don't ask me why. I think you water early here. Just make it easy. Or you could mana worm
mirror entity.
Yeah, actually, that's not that bad. But I think Water Alley is the simpler play.
I do.
Because maybe we'll get a Kieran Tor Mage or something, you know.
See, this is nice. Again, turn four, you're probably looking at a true silver champion. So that's why it's probably a smarter play to use Water Ellie, because...
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, Water Ellie's against, like, Warrior and against Paladin. Just so good.
Mm-hmm.
So good.
And short
Even against Druid isn't bad.
Short of blowing one of his equalities on this, like, removing a 6 health is very difficult for a Pally. Because they just don't have the burst. Am I right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
I think you just drop another Water Ellie and you just hit his face. The other play could be Mana Worm Frostbolt. But then we just ping something.
I think Mana Worm Frostbolt that thing and keep him grounded with okay. The one damage. I think that's okay. Gonna be
I'll dig it. I mean I don't think there's like a wrong play with that. I like developing Water Ellies, but I think this is alright too.
Yeah. This is just to keep him stationary.
Yeah, it's going to keep that Mana Worm alive, because the easiest way to do it is True Silver Champion, just kill it.
Yep.
I think this is easy. I think you just drop your own Sludge Belcher.
Yeah.
You can even hit that with
you think I
Water
should?
Ellie if you want. I don't know if you should.
I think I should. Because that
place around Consecrate.
Yeah. 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 Oh, Counterspell would be really great.
Yeah, Counterspell would be clutch on this board. You guys got to think about like Kieran Tor Mage Counterspell as like a little mini Lotheb.
Yeah, that's a good way to look at it, dude. Ooh.
Well,
do we want to save that?
I think we want to save that. So here's what I think we do. I think we drop Mirror Entity.
Mm-hmm.
I think we ping his Sludge Belcher. Clear it with a 3-1.
Yeah.
Clear that with a...
Clear that.
Mana Worm. And then go face with that.
Yep. Which is really nice, because he's frozen. He's got to play
In
something.
Turn sevens, he's going to play a big minion.
Nice. Cairn.
That's huge! Oh, that was a squeaky voice right there.
Oh, boy.
I think you just play Mad Scientist right now. I think you ping his 1-1. I think you drop Mirror Entity again.
And go for face
with
all of it.
And I think you go face with everything.
Yeah. Man. Man, oh man, oh man. So, in other news, I picked up the WoW again. And I'm playing over on Kul'Tiras Horde side. US, if you are interested. We're going to be rocking out some Warlords in November when it comes out. So, it'll be fun. Fun time. Oh, it's too bad that wasn't... Too bad we didn't have Counterspell. I think Rags.
We can either Rag... I don't want to play into an Equality pyro or equality, whatever.
It's
so here's what I think we do. Oh, what am I saying?
Wait, 2, 3.
No, there's a. Oh my god, I'm bad. sack in the 2-2 into that Karen. Now we have a counter spell. Now you can play Rag.
Oh. I like your style.
And then go face with everything.
Oh, there goes your consecrate.
The good news is no matter what happens, he's going to get equality done. So he has to test this trap with a holy light or something like that. There you go. It's going to counterspell. Then he's going to play like a wild pyro.
Okay. There's lethal.
Done. Nice.
There it is.
4 damage overkill. Well, yeah. 3, but three. You could have gotten the mana worm buff.
It's true. It's true. So that puts us on a win streak, ladies and gentlemen, which means one thing and one thing only. That particular win was, in fact, brought to you by Hee Haw. Let's hear it, guys. It has a complete and total garbage taste. I mean, it's absolutely terrible. It's not our sponsor. It's not affiliated with the show in any way whatsoever. It's got a terrible name. I mean, it's got 3 E's. Come on now. So next time you guys draw lethal on a pally and go into a win streak, I want you to grab yourself a 2-liter Hee Haw. I want you to crack that bad boy open, and I want you to kick the hell out of something. So, there you have it. Right there. All right, man. So, moving right along. Uh-oh. We're at 90 gold right now. I keep toying with death. One of these times, I'm going to get like 3 legendaries and my wife is going to make me not play this game anymore. So, I'm just saying. So, what do you think? All right, Stutter, I'm going to let you choose, dude. One more game or community thoughts? What do you think?
I say we go one more game because we're on a win streak.
Wait, you know what? Actually, no. BFantana11, good call. Good call to you. He wants us to repost the deck list. I don't have the deck list pre-whatever, so let's talk about it again. We got 2 Mana Worms, 2 Undertakers, 2 Frostbolts, 2 Loot Hoarders, 2 Mad Scientists, 2 Counterspells, 1 Duplicate, 2 Mirror Entities, 2 Harvest Golems, 2 Kirin Tor Mages, 2 Fireballs, 1 Polymorph, 2 Water Elementals, Lotheb, 2 Sludge Belchers, Sylvanas, Flamestrike, and Rags. So, there she is again.
One of the things you guys are going to notice is we haven't had use for Flamestrike yet, so that's kind of why people are taking it out.
Yeah, we haven't even drawn it yet. I wonder if there's something better.
Even during that Zoom matchup, it wouldn't even help that much.
I wonder if there's something better. Something better we could put in there. What are your thoughts on an Arcane Intellect or?
I think a bigger creature.
Or an Ice Bear? Or an Ethereal Arcanist? I think a big creature. A big creature, huh?
Yeah. Ethanol Arcanist, you can play it, but you kind of need you need ice blocks to make that worthwhile, because those never go. Those never die. So I'm thinking like maybe a Black Knight or Cairn. What do you think?
I think Black Knight would certainly be nice, because we are running into Sludge Belcher Heaven.
And if you duplicate a Black Knight, oof.
Oh, yeah, get ready. Or maybe even Faceless. Think Black Knight. Or Harrison.
Faces could be all right.
There could be
many
options.
I think let's try the Black Knight.
Okay.
We could play something swag. We could play like Hogger.
Dude, I was thinking Gruul, man.
Gruul is a very fun card to play.
Kel'Thuzad. Kel'Thuzad is my favorite card in this entire game.
It is a lot of fun. Play right. Deathwing.
Oh, dude, Deathwing.
No, let's stick to the Black Knight. All right,
stick with the Black Knight. Stick with the Black Knight. So, alrighty then. The Beast. Actually, I don't have the Beast. Chat room's blowing it up. So
I have opened the Beast 4 times, and I've never kept them.
Really?
Just refuse to keep them. You know, it used to be a 10-6.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they switched him to a 9-7. ERA was playing him in his Hunter deck, though, for a little bit on EU. I think that's because he only had, like, a few legendaries, and he thought swag.
Sure. Oh, here we go. That Black Knight might come in handy.
I think keep Manworm, and I think keep Ice Bolt. Yeah. Or Frost Bolt. Ice Bolt.
Ice Bolt.
Keep that Ice Bolt thing.
Yeah, and the Frost Lance. We'll keep that, too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, very nice. So, we... That... Oh,
maybe I mean, you can just coin out Undertaker, too, if you want.
Well, yeah, I think I will.
Yeah, because it buffs the Mana Worm.
Yeah. Yeah. A 2-3 and a 1-2 on turn 1. That's awesome. Neurogenesis 1 in the chat room says, have you guys played with Ifishu's mage deck? It's super fast.
Yes, I have played with it, and I don't really like it. But it worked for him very well, so who am I to criticize me not liking his deck? I think it caught a lot of people off guard, and I think that's why it won a lot. But once people figured out what to do with it, they're just like, well, whatever. You know, sure. That's what they were thinking. Well, whatever.
Yeah.
I think you just... I mean, you have two choices here. You could Mana Worm and Frostbolt that, but I don't like that. I like Harvest Golem.
Yeah.
Just play Harvest Golem, just develop the board, and just go... I think you just go phase.
Yeah.
Because if he trades with that, you just ping it, yep. And then you can just take care of it yourself.
Yep. And plus, I mean...
This guy got both Wraths. Certainly it was not right. I think you just Mana Worm, and I think you Frostbolt his Harvest Golem. And then I think you can trade in the 2-3 into the Harvest Golem. The second half.
Sure.
Yeah. Because whatever he plays this turn, if he plays like a Sludge Belcher, just fireball it and we just take it out with the second thing, we could play Lotheb after it.
Okay.
Just play Sludge Belcher.
Yep.
And that's just setting up for a fireball thing next turn.
Yep. You think swipe? No.
Well, that's certainly annoying.
Mm-hmm. And that's certainly no help to us.
I think you just drop Lotheb yourself. Yeah, absolutely. Just drop Lotheb yourself. Just end turn.
Yeah. I was thinking, we've got 2, 4, 5, and a hero power 6.
Oh my god! Come on! What the heck? How do you...
Okay. Okay, come on, Black Knight. Come on, Black Knight. Oh.
Ooh, that's good, too, though. I think we just play it.
Think so?
Yeah. Why not? We can just take out the, yep, right there. If that gets silenced, we're like, But he would have silenced something else earlier on. We would have silenced that man worm. He should have.
Even if he silences it and tries to hide behind that 5-10 taunt, we can still fireball and Sylvanas it and get rid of that taunt.
Yeah. So, well, we can fireball that and ping it and then get rid of it with a mana worm if we wanted to.
Yeah, either. I mean, potato, potato. So. No secrets. No. I guess this is kind of good to see, though, man. What happens when you run into this deck and you don't have the secrets? You know? Yeah, kill him,
that
dude.
Is...
Kill him. Do it. Do it. I'll pay you money.
He's probably going to Black Knight himself.
He's going to Black Knight it. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
I think you just Harvest Golem. Actually,
I can kill that Rags. I need to kill that Rag.
Oh, no, you're definitely killing that. Well, you're definitely fireballing and trading in.
Yeah.
But I'm debating what the play is after that. I think it's just Harvest Golem.
Yeah, I think you're right. We've got to be coming up on some secrets here pretty soon.
Yeah. The 4-3 wouldn't be bad just to play out, though.
Oh, come on, Black Knight. Put you in the deck for a reason. Work for us. Work for us. Oh,
I think you just drop Loot Hoarder, Sludge Belcher, and you ping off his shield.
Yeah.
And we don't want to attack in with the Harvest Golem, because that will play into swipe very nicely.
Mm-hmm. That's all this guy is taunts. So
yeah, I mean, we've played this deck.
Yeah.
Like, as this deck.
Yeah. I'm really waiting for, whatchamacallit?
Oh, Rag or Black Knight?
The 8-8. The 8-8 taunt. That's what I'm waiting for him to play.
It's not played in decks, man. That doesn't exist.
You always say that, Stutter.
I do always say that.
And then it rears its ugly head. Oh, that sucks.
We'll trade in the Loot Hoarder into the... Yep. The 6-4. Trade in the 2-3 into the 6-2. I think you Kirin Tor Mage.
And then Mirror
Entity. I think you Mirror Entity, and I don't think you duplicate.
No, because that's going to give me 1-2 taunts, and I don't want that.
Yep. Well, you could sack the 1-2.
I don't want to.
Oh, we don't want to do that.
No.
Yeah, I think you just ping the Sludge Belcher after this. Sludge Belcher.
Okay.
Because if he trades in, yeah, you're right. You might have wanted to ping the face.
That helps.
That also helps. I think you Rag right now. Yep. Alright, and then you ping the 3-5. You kill it with the Cure and Tor Mage. And then you kill the first half of the Belch.
Yeah.
With the... Yeah. Now, if that's BGH, we're not doing well.
Eh.
Do we want a duplicate and counterspell?
I kind of think we do.
I think we do, too. Yep. And then we ping the Sludge Belcher, and that's it. And that's just an insurance play. Yeah, absolutely. Yep, and then just sit.
Rag's doing some work.
I hope BGH is a rag right now.
Even still... If he kills it, we're going to get two Sengins, which will be nice. Okay.
That last card is Savage Roar, I bet you.
Think so?
Mm-hmm.
Play it all?
I think you I think you just play the two Sengins, yeah. And then you just ping his little dude. Hit the 4/4.
Oh, I thought you were telling me to. I was like, dude, I already ended the turn. It's too late.
No. I wanted the rag to hit the 4/4. I think that's also better than hitting face, to be honest.
No swipe for you.
I would play Undertaker, Mad Scientist, and then I would just go face with everything.
Yeah. Actually, I think I should ping and take one out and take out that 4/4.
You think?
I think I should.
I mean, he showed he can't deal with this.
Yeah, but I don't want to give him a chance to. I don't know. I just I like clearing his board, man. I like playing it precautionary.
And that guarantees 8 damage to his face, too.
Yep.
But I just figured that he couldn't deal with it, so I was like, just go all to the face. Rag can hit whatever he wants. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
That was a good win. We got through two Ancient of Wars.
Yep.
A Sunwalker.
Yep.
And two Belchers.
We did it without the Black Knight, ladies and gentlemen. So he's really paying off, as you can see. But I can tell you what, that Flamestrike wouldn't have helped us very much either. So.
The Flamestrike would have been like, well, nothing we can do about this.
Yeah, absolutely. Squat. So, anyways.
I mean, the turning point was Mirror Entity with Kieran Tormage.
That's exactly right. I don't know what you just said because I'm trying to plan out my next step with everything that's going on. So, actually, the next step, ladies and gentlemen, is where we reach out and we grab onto the thoughts of the community. We put our fingers on the pulse and see what people are saying about this game, Hearthstone, that we love so dearly. And. Here is a little bit of what's going on this week. There is somebody who thinks that Mage Secrets are a !!!! game design. So pick your expletive deleted. And this is by the one and the only Pay to Win is his name. So let's just go ahead and cue that up, shall we? Let's do that. Pay to Win says secrets are a expletive deleted game design. Zero counterplay other than 1, predicting it's a secrets mage, 2, having an Iron Beak Owl in your deck and actually drawing it by turn 2, or 3, being a hunter. You basically just stuck in a chain loop of LOL mad scientist, LOL duplicates, LOL counterspell, LOL sludge belcher, non-stop secrets with no ways to remove them other than wasting cards or being a hunter. So, I'll be brutally honest with you, dude. That very first paragraph, zero counterplay other than one, predicting it's a secrets mage, two, having an iron beak owl in your deck and actually drawing it by turn two, or three, being a hunter. That whole entire sentence has lost me. It has fallen off the grammar table, and it is sliding down away from life as we know it. It makes no sense. I'm completely lost. But I'm going to take that and just let it wash over me for a while. It feels so good.
I don't understand how Iron Peak Owl is a counter to secrets. I mean, I can kind of, like, understand almost where it's coming from with Mad Scientist, but it's like, really?
Really? Come on, man. Come on, man. I hear ya. All right, let's play another game and see what happens here. See how this goes. So, yeah. And the guy's name is even Pay to Win. I mean, hey, guys, Pay to Win's on the forums. Get ready.
Just to let you guys all know, also, we're going to try to have an English teacher on the show to, well, really just even help more dissect these community thoughts.
All right.
We're going to bring him in. We're going to fly him in from Dubai because all English teachers are good in Dubai.
Yep. He's on break from Dell Tech support. Should I keep the Harvest Golem or no?
I don't think so. I mean, this is the toughest matchup. So we need early aggression.
We don't get it though.
This is such a tough matchup because he has so many more one drops and he has flare.
Yeah.
This is not what we wanted.
Nope. Might keep that bow in check though.
That's nice.
We also have so many secrets. I don't know. This is going to be a tough one. What's that, Sutter?
It said be one with the cards.
Yeah.
I think you just play Mad Scientist.
Yeah.
Yep, Mad Scientist. Because our next turn can be Mana Worm Ping or Mana Worm Frostbolt or Mana Worm insert other card here.
Yeah. Mana Worm Ragnaros. And face.
I think you play the Mana Worm. I think you clear the 1/1 with the
Hero Power.
No. With the 2/2 with the Mad Scientist.
Okay.
And then I think you Frostbolt the Yep. No, that's probably a freezing trap.
Yeah, it was random. So you never know.
I would just hit it. Like, you're going to have to pop that trap sometime, so just go in with that. Yeah. Yep. And then just play Water Ellie.
Now, why wouldn't I want a Mana Worm Frostbolt?
Because Water Allies get better in the long
okay.
run. Because this is more mana efficient.
Okay.
That's really the only answer. And Water Ally can freeze them for a long time.
Okay.
Are you kidding me?
No way, dude. I saw it coming from a mile away. Yeah.
Who plays that, though?
Hungry
Deadly
Crab.
Shot has been out of the meta forever. A Sludge Belcher. I mean, he drew the Hungry Crab off of there.
Yeah.
But man, Deadly Shot has been like out of the meta forever, guys. Like
Here's the thing. I agree. It's not. It's out of the meta at legendary rank where you're at. Yes, it's out of the meta at rank 7, 6, 5. and higher, it's still very much a part of the meta. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true. We could do Manaworm. I think the play is Manaworm right now. Frostbolt to 4-3. Ping 3-1. I think we would play Undertaker just for the heck of it and go phase. Undertaker would allow us something to freezing trap. As well as we can buff it with Mad Scientist next turn.
Mm-hmm. Man.
I would Kirin Tor Mage, Mirror Entity right now. I'm debating what to do now.
Should we Mad Scientist?
I think Mad Scientist is fine.
Because that's going to buff that.
Yeah. And I think we're going to have to trade in the 1-2 and the 3-3.
Yeah.
And that. Yep. And just go face with that.
It is really nice not
Flare.
To. Yeah.
I'm hoping he plays high main right now. Come on. I don't know what he did that for.
I think he's setting up for a high main. A give you no way of dealing with it. Ugh.
That was so. I don't know. I guess this guy's good. What?
Ah. That feels good. Well, that's
give us rag right now.
That's his second Houndmaster, isn't it?
Yeah. So you can just play Black Knight out.
Yeah. And I'm going to ping that 4-1.
Yep, and go face with the 1-2.
The thing that sucks is that is a wide-open kill command waiting to happen with that beast.
That's all right, though, because then that prevents him from playing high main.
That's true. That's true. Looking at the... The good in everything, Stutter.
I would play Loot Hoarder right now. I would just hit his face and go face. Because we have better finishing cards right now than him.
You think it's worth pinging my Loot Hoarder?
No, but I do think it's worth pinging his. No, we can always ping it next turn. Yeah, I would actually ping his Haunted Creeper. Yep.
Buzzard Unleash.
I got Buzzard Unleashed. I played in casual mode and I got Buzzard Unleashed. I was like, are you kidding me?
But we still have the Polymorph in the deck.
Oh, my God. I would just play both those out. I would ping his his Loot Hoarder.
Yeah.
Yep, and I would trade the 1-2 with the one of the 1/1s, yeah. He does know he didn't have to play that, right?
You always play Unleash. Always.
Well, our only hope of winning now is top decking Polymorph.
Nope.
Well, play Lotheb. Kill one of the hounds with that 1/1. Yep. Yeah. Ping the other hound. And go face with that.
He needs 2 damage, basically.
We have another out. Well, he needs... Yeah. We have a few outs now. We don't have any outs anymore.
Nope. That's GG.
Actually, if you drew Polymorph there, that would have been an out. Yep, that's good. It's game.
That's game. 2, 3.
Hunters are still stupid, guys.
Yep.
The guy drew 2 high mains back to back, though. It's like nothing you can do about that.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Agreed.
So I hate when people say well played.
I know. I got nothing. Arcane missiles. I don't play Mage very much. I don't know. It's not for me. So, but anyways, not a bad deck. It's got its ups and its downs. I mean, we didn't get flared, which is cool. I mean, you know.
He beat me. Aranya, straight up. Said, I wonder what...
Pay him. Pay that man his money.
Sorry, I should give you more of a heads up before I blast the soundboard.
It's fine. So Aranya asked, I wonder what would happen if Milhouse and Lotheb were on the board at the same time. We have an article about that. Also, basically the gist of the article says, if you play Lotheb first, then you play Milhouse, everything's free.
Yep.
If you play Milhouse first, then Lotheb, everything's 5 mana.
Right. It's all about the order, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it's all about the order.
It's all about the order. Absolutely.
If you play, Lotheb, then Milhouse, then Shadow Step Lotheb, then it's everything's 5 mana.
Yeah.
If you play Milhouse, then Lotheb, Shadow Step Lotheb, then everything's 10 mana.
Everything's 10 mana. So,
yep.
There's a mosquito in here that has got a death wish, and it's going to go down after the show. So, just know, when the credits roll, the world will be one mosquito less. So, really quick, guys, here's what's going on. If you notice, one thing about our Twitch channel that other Twitch channels don't have is we have a follow button that you can click, and you get an email when we go live or a notification on your phone or however it is. That you are notified when your favorite Twitch TV channels go live. But we don't have a subscribe button. We don't ask for money. We don't ask for any of that stuff. We do this for fun. We do this for education. We do this just because I'm a 34-year-old male with 2 kids, and I got nothing else to do on Monday nights. So what you can do is follow us, and you can help spread the word. Tweet about us. Tell your friends about us. Do whatever. That mosquito is criminal. One of the best ways that you can help others find us is to give us 5-star reviews on iTunes. When people type in Hearthstone, it helps. The more 5-star reviews we have, the better chance we have at being found by people who are looking to enjoy a show that you enjoy, like ours. So we have 3 of them this week. Amazing. Absolutely awesome. 3 iTunes reviews. The first one is from Balrog Fan. I'm going to screw that up till the day I die. And he says, I laugh and learn every week. When I first stumbled upon this show, I was a player who made bad decisions and played bad decks. After one viewing, I was hooked. This show has not only made me a better player, but has become one of my favorite activities in the week. Twiz is a great is the greatest host to ever grace a podcast, and Sutter's a top-notch player who has great instincts along with wonderful insights into the amazing game of Hearthstone. The two complement each other so well and provide a great platform for learning and humor. If you find yourself playing Hearthstone and you want to become a better player, just watch one episode and you will understand the greatness of Twiz and Sutter. We got another one from Ictegem, I think it is. I-C-H-T-E-G-E-M, Ictegem, one of a kind. He says, these guys are great. They're making the best podcast out there for learning how to really play Hearthstone, and they're having fun doing it. Suited both for pretty early players and for more experienced types. And lastly, Crystal Black says, get your learn on in epic style. From the great video intro to the end, these two guys help you play better. I probably watch every episode 3 times. It is exactly what I want. Real game instruction with lively commentary. With this podcast, it is about the meta, decks, and card play. Perfect. So, everybody, thank you so much for the 5-star reviews. It means a lot. That's the kind of stuff that just fuels our fire and keeps us going and wanting us to come back, do this every week and everything like that. It's a thank you. It's a tip of the hat. And we certainly appreciate it. It does wonders for us. So I think that's going to do it for this episode. One thing I do want to bring up real quick, guys, is if you missed the beginning, check out BlizzPro's Extra Life event. Go to extralife.blizzpro.com, and you will be able to see everything that we have going on. It's such a great charity. I cannot say enough about it. And if you want to sign up and do your own thing, make sure you go to extra-life.org. I can't think of a better, that's where I go for my donations and giving to charity and everything like that every year. So, let's see here. Standard things. Hearthstone Facebook page. Give it a like if you're on Facebook and you like us. You can follow me on Twitter at TwizBP. You can follow Stutter. He's got like the longest name ever, and I wish I could fit it in the box here. But it is at A-N-T-S-X-I Stutter BP. And, oops, sorry. And, you know, we're chit-chatting about whatever and talking about whatever. So hit us up on Twitter if you got any questions, comments, concerns, or anything else like that. Make sure you're going to hearthstone.blizzpro.com for all of your Hearthstone news. Hook it up to the RSS reader on your phone, on your tablet, or whatever, and get your daily Hearthstone newspaper from there and BlizzPro's, all of BlizzPro's websites. Check out the Westmarch Workshop if you're a Diablo freak, Archon 9 Ball. And they have a new co-host that you should definitely check out. I'm not going to give any spoilers here, but Steven does a great job. The Edge, which is BlizzPro's WoW show. Great things going on over there. Valise, Maticus, other awesome names, personalities, video gameplay, talking about Warlords coming out. I'm on the Kul'Tiras US server. If you're going to play Warlords and you want to roll and hang and whatever, come and visit me. And I believe, actually, Stutter, you're on the Kul'Tiras server, am I correct?
Right, I have a level one character.
Yes.
I made him, and I was like, I don't know if I'll ever get into this game, but he's there now.
He's there. He exists. Well on his way. Excellent. So, very cool.
Here's something interesting.
What's up?
Little rant.
Yeah.
So I can put Sexy Stutter as my Hearthstone name. That's S-E-X-I-S-T-U-D-D-E-R. But on WoW, I can only put SXI.
Okay.
So they made me take out the E.
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Because there's like trigger phrases and trigger words and trigger names. Okay, I used
but
to have a...
why isn't there that in Hearthstone?
Because it's a battle tag thing. It's not a WoW character name. It's a battle tag thing. And Hearthstone's the only game where your battle tag is showing. Am I right?
And not I don't
your,
even know.
Not your character name.
All I know is Hearthstone. People have like... the like... people's names aren't just like, they're like racist.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
Sexist.
Yeah.
They're like brutal.
Kicking out some serious craziness.
Yeah.
I know it, dude. I know it. But no, I used to have a druid, and his name was Fuzzy Lil Nuts, and it was NUTZ. And I got away with it for a long time until Blizzard picked up on the NUTZ thing. And that was the end of that. So now you can't have anything with the word nuts in it, I don't think, or at least that's how it used to be. So, anyways, there's a little sneak peek into my stupid WoW life. So, anyways, guys, we'll be back next Monday night. Stutter, anything you want to say to everybody again before we leave?
I mean, just shout out to BlizzPro, shout out to Twiz, shout out to Antares. You guys have heard it all before. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Hee Haw, most importantly.
That is, you're damn right. Absolutely. Next week, we are going to be featuring a rogue deck. And Stutter, you want to wet the whistle a little bit on this rogue deck we're going to feature?
It's going to be old school. It's going to be tempo style. And you know what? I'm not sure how well it's going to work, but I think it's going to work well.
The bane of my existence. I'm going to get him. I'm going to get him. Freaking insects. All right. Tempo Rogue next week, ladies and gentlemen. You saw it here. We are going to be all over it. So check us out. Twitch.tv/TwizzCast Monday nights at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific. So this is the part where I am not stalling and I have to try and get the music going again. And I got him. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, we'll call it a night. Have a great week. We'll see you then.